Hello, my name is Judith Heinrich.
And my name is Tudor Morgan, and we are expedition leaders for Hurtigruten.
Today we will talk about a destination, or rather, an experience that is all about unique modern-day exploring. These are raw and legendary expedition cruises and true bucket list adventures to places that has barely changed since man first set foot on them, or rather, sailed there. We invite you to explore some of the most inaccessible places in the world with us, the legendary Northwest Passage in Arctic Canada.
That is correct, Judith. And we offer two different cruises in the area, an attempted crossing of the entire Northwest Passage, sailing from Nome in Alaska to Halifax in Canada, and an attempted circumnavigation of Baffin Island through the entrance of the Northwest Passage, which starts and ends in Greenland. And when I say attempted crossing and attempted circumnavigation, there is a good reason for that, isn't it, Judith?
It sure is. But before we get into that, why don't we give a lecture in geography and history, even if some of our viewers don't really need it. After all, as a member of the Hurtigruten expedition team, hosting lectures about our destinations is a big part of our job. The Northwest Passage is the sea route between the Atlantic Ocean and the Pacific Ocean along the northern coast of North America and Arctic Canada. European explorers have since 1497, as far as history can tell us, searched for a trade route into Asia. Back then, it was the English King Henry VII who commissioned Italian navigator and explorer Giovanni Caboto, also known as John Cabot, to search for a route to East Asia through North America. At that time, Cabot was probably the first European to reach mainland North America since the Vikings. However, it appeared he only made it to Newfoundland before returning to England.
Several explorers tried and failed to find a passage in the centuries that followed. For instance, the Fury and Hecla Strait is named after two Royal Navy ships which became stuck there in 1821. But one of the best known attempts is that of British explorer Sir John Franklin. In 1845, in his third attempt to sail and map the Northwest Passage, he sailed with two powerful and luxurious ships named HMS Terror and HMS Erebus, and the confidence among his men was high. However, the expeditions never returned to England. There were several search parties in the years that followed until relics and graves were found on Beechey Island and King William Island in the 1850s. A note was also found saying that the Franklin crew had abandoned the ships when they became trapped in the ice in 1846, and that Franklin had died in 1847. The ships weren't discovered until 2014 and 2016.
But as it happens, one man's failure is another man's success. In 1903, Norwegian explorer Roald Amundsen and his crew of six set sail on a small ship called Gjøa, spending two winters off King William Island in what is now called Gjøa Haven. They learned from the local Netsilik Inuit people on how to survive in the Arctic. And in August 1905, they finally emerged out of the Canadian Arctic as the first people to journey through the passage entirely by ship. So there you have it, maybe your first lecture in Northwest Passage history from the Hurtigruten expedition team.
In recent years, because of global warming and climate change, the Northwest Passage is more open for a few weeks in the Arctic summer. And that is when we will make our move. But even if the waters are more open now compared to earlier, it doesn't mean they are ice-free, but that the ice is more mobile and can move around more. In this part of the world, nature dictates and rules. The unpredictable sea ice and weather conditions will determine our final itinerary. We might come across stretches that are still ice-covered. In some cases, that's okay because icebreakers may be available, helping us to make our way through the ice. However, if not, we will adjust our course accordingly.
This is why these voyages in these areas are not carved in stone. We have to prepare each day as it comes. but this is also why these voyages are more adventurous than any other of our expedition cruises. We prepare for the unexpected, which is basically what successful exploring is all about. Adventure is when you're not entirely sure what the next day will bring. If we knew exactly what was waiting for us, we wouldn't be exploring. So make no mistake, going to the Northwest Passage and Arctic Canada with Hurtigruten will let you follow on the wake of the great explorers like John Cabot, Sir John Franklin, and Roald Amundsen. Only you get to explore from a new hybrid-powered expedition cruise ship, far beyond the comfort and facilities the early explorers and their crew could ever have imagined.
Without a doubt. And we will do our best and utmost to make it through the Northwest Passage in its entirety or to circumnavigate the whole of Baffin Island, depending on the voyage you choose. Because Baffin Island and the areas and the waters around are our main destination for our second cruise here. So how can you best describe Baffin Island?
Well, let me see. Baffin Island is located at the eastern entrance of the Northwest Passage in the Canadian territory of Nunavut. It is the largest island in Canada, the fifth largest in the world, and contains two national parks with spectacular fjords, glaciers, steep peaks, and cliffs. It is habited for polar bears, caribou, rabbit, Arctic fox, and Arctic and Baffin Island wolf. There are more than 100 species of birds, including phalarope, waders, murres and plovers, snow owls, falcons and hawks. Whales like the narwhal, beluga, white whale and the bowhead whale can be seen. In addition to walrus and harp seals, which thrives in the surrounding waters. The island has been inhabited for more than 3,000 years, first by the pre-Dorset, then by the Dorset, and then the Tulu people, the ancestors of the Inuit, who have lived on the island for the last 1,000 years.
Yes, Baffin Island is, without a doubt, an area of great natural and cultural richness. And also mystery, it seems. The Fury and Hecla Strait is located on the northwest side of Baffin Island. It is the site of an unexplained phenomena simply called the ping. The sound is described as acoustic anomalies that seem to scare off sea animals and nobody knows the source of it. Maybe we can find out on our next expedition there. But I digress. Baffin Island is in itself an adventure that has to be experienced. And even though we are talking about two different expedition cruises in this area, with the Northwest Passage and Baffin Island, the two have a lot in common. Which cruise you choose? You will explore unspoiled fjords to witness mesmerizing scenery, massive glaciers, and ice landscapes. We will go cruising in our small boats through the ice floes and go ashore for hikes, land at historic places, and visit traditional Inuit communities.
Yes, we have to talk a little bit more about the Inuit. They have, like I said earlier, lived here for the last 1,000 years, and they are descendants to the first indigenous group that crossed the Bering Strait sometime around 3000 BC and moved into the Canadian Arctic archipelago. Their native language is called Inuktitut, but a lot of the 39,000 Inuit people living in the Northwest Territories, also called Nunavut, speak English. The traditional lifestyle of the Inuit are adapted to the extreme Arctic conditions. Hunting, fishing, and trapping are at the core of Inuit culture. In fact, everyday life in modern Inuit communities, which in some cases were established only a few decades ago, still reflect the 5,000-year-old history of a nomadic hunter-gatherer tradition. They hunt out of necessity and use every part of the animal. And just like Roald Amundsen and his crew made contact with the Inuit back in 1903, Hurtigruten has also established a close and respectful cooperation with the local Inuit communities, working together as trusted friends and collaborators.
That's right. We will spend quality time with our Inuit friends on both voyages. But now we have to move on to some other things there are to explore and discover on our voyages. On our expedition through the Northwest Passage, we plan to go whale spotting in the Beaufort Sea, witness the amazing Smoking Hills phenomenon in Cape Bathurst, and visit Devon Island, the largest uninhabited island on Earth. We also plan to go ashore on Beachy Island to pay our respects at the final resting place for three members of the Franklin expedition that you mentioned earlier, Judith.
Devon Island and Beachy Island will also be visited on the Buffin Island expedition. We plan to visit Fort Russ, an abandoned Hudson's Bay trading post, and Aptamok Island, surrounded by towering limestone cliffs. And we aim to visit Cape Dorset, which is internationally recognized for its many Inuit artists. And since the Baffin Island expedition is starting and ending in Greenland, we will also spend some wonderful days exploring there.
We will of course be spending a lot of time on the ship on these voyages, but there will also be excursions and activities like we usually have on a Hurtigruten expedition cruise. Depending on your voyage, we will witness a kayak demonstration and visit the museum in Sisimiut. We will go on a walk to the ice fjords in Ilulissat. You can go on a lighthouse journey or historical walking tour in Red Bay, take the Marble Mountain zip line in Corner Brook, and a number of other included and optional excursions.
We will also be spending a lot of time with our expert expedition team, who will host lectures and science activities in our onboard science center. Their mixture of enthusiastic stories and edutainment will help you learn and understand more about the areas we explore to give you a fuller and more complete experience of our adventures together. They will also take you on landings and scout for whales and other wildlife, take you kayaking and go on ice cruising in our small expedition boats.
On sea days, and when we are not ashore on excursions and activities, your home and headquarters will be our amazing hybrid power expedition ship. Keep yourself in motion in our indoor and outdoor gym, complete with a 150 meter outdoor running track. Relax sore muscles in our wellness center and spa. Enjoy the incredible scenery through the floor to ceiling windows in the Explorer Lounge and Bar, and treat your taste buds to exquisite courses in our three onboard restaurants. There is also an infinity pool and two hot tubs on deck 10, where you can sit or swim comfortably in heated water while we glide through beautiful, pristine, icy landscapes.
Yes, there will never be a dull moment exploring the raw and remote beauty of Northwest Passage and Arctic Canada with Hurtigruten. These two voyages are the crème de la crème of polar exploration. And we promise you, you will never nor will ever experience anything quite like this ever again.